Okay, yeah.
So
yeah.
I'm not saying I disagree. He's got his opinion, I got mine.
Sure, sure, sure.
And he's got, and he, you know, he's very deserving of his opinion because of who he is.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I'm just looking at it differently.
Okay.
I'm looking at it that this guy was an Olympian. This guy went to London and beat Kell Brook. This guy, you know, this guy has done everything you've asked of him. I believe what I've seen.
I got you.
I don't think it's a mirage.
Okay, I got you.
I believe that when he wants to be relentless, he's relentless. I believe that he's a terrific body puncher. I do believe that he's more than just that, that he's technically sound in a lot of areas, that he can switch it up, that he can be very versatile, he can counter, he can box, he can go get you.
Yeah, yeah.
I believe he can do all those things. And I believe that he believes. That's where it comes from for me. That he believes that he's always going to do that.
Okay.
And that's enough for me.
And right, you believe in B. Crawford, right? I think you've said that before.
Yeah, I mean, listen, it'd be very interesting. It'd be very interesting. I love Crawford. It'd be very interesting. Crawford is, you know, he brings a different dimension to it. I mean, you're talking about a guy who's tall and long, stepped up in weight classes, you know, and a guy who's a winner, a guy who's dynamic, but a guy who goes about his business in a different way, where he controls range, where, you know, he looks to set traps. But then he believes too, Crawford. That's what makes, that would be an intriguing fight for me, because that son of a gun, he believes too. When it gets down to it, to being a junkyard dog, man, he could bite with the best of them. Because you try to take something from him, he'll say, you know what, I like to control range, I like to be out of here, I like to counter, I like to have it my way, just like you guys like to have a buffet and all things when I hope he put some food out for you guys.
Not so much.
You talk like to him about that.
Yeah, really, really, that ain't right. But everyone wants to have what is most comfortable for themselves. And yeah, Crawford would love to have that, but when he don't have that, and he has to go to the other place, he has shown you, and I've seen it, where he'll say, freak it, I'll fight you right here. I'll do whatever I got. And he's got one other thing that might even be better than what Spence has. And you didn't expect me to say that. He's got tremendous instincts. He's got, you know, Spence has, I stand by my word. Spence is physical, he's technically solid, he's an Olympian, you know, he's put together the right way. And he mentally has that desire. He believes. But so does Crawford. But he's got this, he's got an instinctual presence to him that I haven't seen with too many fighters.
Doesn't he do even some of the things the guys in the black and white did?
You know what he does?
Sorry.
He does what my mentor, who I think was the, hey, I'm prejudiced, he was the greatest boxing guy ever, Customano, said that the special ones do. He makes it up as he does it. Not too many people can do that. He's like a Louis Armstrong that can create a new tone right there on the stage with the horn that you never heard before. And that's what Crawford can do. And that's pretty damn special. And that's why I can't just close my eyes and say, hey, you know, I favor Spence in that fight, but it'd be a fight that